Hello and welcome to episode 95 of Nugget's Dungeon Terrain. This is the fourth part of the Abandoned Mine series. In this episode, I'll be showing the latest three sections, starting with the Dead End. To make this section, I'm using a flat scrap and a block scrap. The flat scrap is 2 centimeters high, which I use for all of my bases, so that they match up. The other scrap is 4 centimeters high. Together it will make the standard heights. With the basic structure complete, I use a soldering iron to create the rock texture and carefully avoid wherever the supporting beams will go. As I place the top section on, you'll notice, in spite of the fact that the two pieces started off the same shape, it has warped and gone outwards. Because it's thinner, the heat changes the shape. This is why I think it's particularly important to use pins to hold these pieces in shape. I placed a pebble as a starting point for some more debris at the end of the cave. You'll notice in the end section I've melted away some little divots. This is where some of the gem-rich ore will be placed. I decided to build the cave-in section to make it look like it could either be a full cave-in that blocks continued passage, or a partial cave-in that bottlenecks the group, maybe as a monster charges them down. Corner sections are great for creating suspense. Who knows what that is just around the bend? They're also really handy if you don't have a lot of space on the table to lay out your map. On the inside of the bend, I want to put this column of stone. I want to make it look like the miners picked around the hard rock to try and find the gems. And finally, here's a quick look at the three pieces joined together in a couple of different combinations.